Welcome to Fight or Not to Fight Ministries. So guys, God has put on my heart this morning to read Psalm 18 for you guys. Some of you guys can use this on your way to work or picking up your children from school. You could use it in the house, you know, if you just need some encouragement. It was yesterday afternoon at the church that God gave me a vision in my mind of Psalm 18. And to give you guys a little background, before God actually gave me this vision, I had left from church and I received a really discouraging text from my spouse. And to be fair, when I left from church, I did speak with my spouse about something that God had put on my heart. Nothing bad, but it was a word that would definitely cause self-reflection. And looking back, I realized my spouse was not in a place to receive this word. And this prompted him to send me a text that was not ill-spirited, but as I said previously, it was very discouraging. I read the text and I responded, and normally I would respond angry and bitter to that type of text and just be upset, but this time I didn't. I just asked the Holy Spirit to speak through me, and I responded in love despite the hurt and the pain I felt. Even though I responded graciously, I was feeling really low. So I went to the bathroom, guys, and I just laid a towel down on the floor and I just cried. I just cried out to God because the hurt was just too much in that moment. And the enemy just started to bring up every bad place, every negative outcome I had been going through. And it was really just too much for me to bear. And I just couldn't do it alone. I couldn't bear that weight. And looking back, the enemy was attacking me with the spirit of depression. Imagine, I just had left from church, had a great time in the Lord, and then this happened. I was like, God, just when I thought things are finally turning, that God is hearing me. The word at church was so strong, so encouraging. I was happy. And then the enemy comes in and tries to sow doubt. And I know that was nothing but the enemy. So as I just laid down on the floor and I cried out to the Lord, I just said, God, please, please help me. I just said, God, save me. I don't know what to do anymore, God. I don't know where to go, what to do. I just don't know. And my very first words were actually, God, please do not let this thing kill me. Do not let me die in this, God, because that's just how low I felt. I felt so low, like less than nothing. I was literally a mess. Sometimes when we're bombarded with just negative thoughts of everything that went wrong in our lives and just every area of our lives, different areas of our life, we could just become so low. You feel like you're in a place where you feel like you can literally die, right? Because that's how heartbroken you are. That's just how much pain you feel at that time when you reflect back sometimes on life, you know, on just different areas of your life. So that's really where I was, and I just wanted to be as raw and transparent with you guys as I possibly can. I just laid out and I cried, and as I was laying with my eyes closed, I saw the letters Psalm 18 in red letters. So I knew that was God prompting me to read it. I didn't really know what Psalm 18 was about before. I didn't really know what Psalm 18 was about before that. So I just got my phone and I looked it up. And once I read the title, God, the Sovereign Savior, I just cried because I said, God, you heard me. You would hear somebody like me that's just on the floor crying, and you're the God who created the universe. You're the God who knows the numbers of stars that you placed in the sky. You heard my little cry, even little me. And I was honestly just amazed. And I know God loves me, right? But it's just beautiful when he tangibly speaks to you so clear. It's just so beautiful. But yeah, so basically, I just want to read Psalm 18 to uplift and encourage someone who is or was in the place that I was, crying in the bed or in the car. I just want you to know that God hears you. He sees every tear. He loves you. And really quick, after I read Psalm 18, I heard the Lord say this. He said, this is what's happening right now in the realms of the spirit. What you read is how I feel about you. This is what is taking place. Although you cannot see it with the physical eye, this is what is happening. So guys, just keep that in mind as I read it. Psalms 18, God, the Sovereign Savior. I will love you, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. The pangs of death surrounded me, and the floods of ungodliness made me afraid. The sorrows of Sheol surrounded me. The snares of death confronted me. In my distress, I call upon the Lord and cried out to my God. He heard my voice from his temple, and my cry came before him, even to his ears. Then the earth shook and trembled. The foundation of the hills also quaked and were shaken. Because he was angry, smoke went up from his nostrils, and devouring fire from his mouth. Coals were kindled by it. He bowed the heavens also and came down with darkness under his feet, and he rode upon a cherub and flew. He flew upon the wings of the wind. He made darkness his secret place. His canopy around him was dark waters and thick clouds of the skies. From the brightness before him, his thick clouds passed with hailstones and coals of fire. The Lord thundered from heaven, and the Most High uttered his voice, hailstones and coals of fire. He sent out his arrows and scattered the foe, lightnings in abundance, and he vanquished them. Then the channels of the sea were seen, the foundations of the world were uncovered. At your rebuke, O Lord, at the blast of the breath of your nostrils, he sent from above, he took me. He drew me out of many waters. He delivered me from my strong enemy, from those who hated me, for they were too strong for me. They confronted me in the day of my calamity, but the Lord was my support. He also brought me out into a broad place. He delivered me because he delighted in me. The Lord rewarded me according to my righteousness. According to the cleanliness of my hands, he has recompensed me. For I have kept the ways of the Lord, and have not wickedly departed from my God. For all his judgments were before me, and I did not put away his statutes from me. I was also blameless before him, and I kept myself from my iniquity. Therefore the Lord has recompensed me according to my righteousness, according to the cleanness of my hands in his sight. With the merciful you will show yourself merciful. With a blameless man you will show yourself blameless. With the pure you will show yourself pure. And with the devious you will show yourself shrewd. For you will save the humble people, but will bring down haughty looks. For you will light my lamp. The Lord my God will enlighten my darkness. For by you I can run against a troop. By my God I can leap over a wall. As for God, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord is proven. He is a shield to all who trust in him. For who is God except the Lord? And who is a rock except our God? It is God who arms me with strength and makes my way perfect. He makes my feet like the feet of deer and sets me on my high places. He teaches my hand to make war so that my arms can bend a bow of bronze. You have also given me the shield of your salvation. Your right hand has held me up. Your gentleness has made me great. You enlarged my path under me, so my feet did not slip. I have pursued my enemies and overtaken them. Neither did I turn back again until they were destroyed. I have wounded them so that they could not rise. They have fallen under my feet, for you have armed me with strength for the battle. You have subdued under me those who rose up against me. You have also given me the necks of my enemies, so that I destroyed those who hated me. They cried out, but there was none to save, even to the Lord, but he did not answer them. Then I beat them as fine as a dust before the wind. I cast them out like dirt in the streets. You have delivered me from the strivings of the people. You have made me the head of the nations. A people I have not known shall serve me. As soon as they hear of me, they obey me. The foreigners submit to me. The foreigners fade away and come frightened from their hideouts. The Lord lives. Blessed be my rock. Let the God of my salvation be exalted. It is God who avenges me and subdues the people under me. He delivers me from my enemies. You also lift me up above those who rise against me. You have delivered me from the violent man. Therefore, I will give thanks to you, O Lord, among the Gentiles, and sing praises to your name. Great deliverance he gives to his king and shows mercy to his anointed, to David and his descendants forevermore. God's anger is kindled against your enemies. Your suffering is coming to an end. God has heard your cry. Your cry has gone up to him. He has heard. God is coming to deliver you because he delights in you. He has seen your righteousness. This is for those who are obedient. He has seen your faithfulness. You have taken heed to his word. I just want to thank you guys so much for listening. I pray that this truly has blessed you. And until next time.